I'm here at the Guildford Park Run. Behind me there are a lot of people about to run precisely 5 kilometres. It's not just happening here, there are hundreds of park runs across the UK, thousands internationally, and because it's such a precise distance that lots of people are running, and you can track your stats across every single park run you go to, it attracts a lot of stats nerds. Speaking of stats nerds, I'm here with my friend Geoff Marshall, who you may know from the YouTube channel
Geoff Marshall.
Yep, yep. And Geoff sent me an email possibly a year or two ago, pre-pandemic, and said there's a thing called Parkrun Bingo.
Yes. When you get your official finish time, not what your watch says, but you get a position and a time, and if you take the second part, the actual seconds of the time, so say you finish in 24 minutes and 12 seconds, you take that 12, there's an unofficial challenge. Can you tick off to say you've done all 60 positions from zero through to 59?
Nice. And have you done this?
We worked it out. We were on a train somewhere. Yep. On the day we did Platform Zero, it took me 229 runs to tick off all 60. But I gather on average...
Well, hey, what? No spoilers. No spoilers.
It takes longer.
Geoff did it in 229. The question is that above or below average?
Okay.
We're going to run the numbers on this.
Yes.
But the thing is, you've already done it, which means there's no narrative for my video.
So I've brought some friends.
Some friends who have not done it. And I've printed out what times they have and have not yet achieved. So you and your mates are going to run the park run.
Yes.
I'm going to do the maths of if you're above or below average.
Okay.
And then we'll see, this is the jeopardy, if any of your friends get a new time. I'm here with friends of Geoff. And Emily, you're only missing like 5. That's amazing. So if you could aim for like the 12 and a half.
I think that's the plan, and then maybe get the 16 instead.
Exactly. You can
sort
overshoot slightly.
By the end.
You got a strategy. I've also printed out all the numbers for Matt.
Hello.
And Matt, you've got a running channel.
I do, yes.
So Runderground, highly recommended. You're missing like 10.
Something like that. Do you know what? I've got it all prepared. I've got it all written down.
You've got them in your hat.
This is how serious I'm taking
it. Oh, that's so good. Okay, all right. Mark, you're exactly halfway. You've got 30 of 60. So there's a 50-50 chance you'll get a new one by the end. So I'll let these guys go and prep, and I'm going to go do some calculations. Park Run Bingo is actually an example of something called Stopwatch Bingo, where you're just trying to collect all the different seconds, assuming this happens at random. And it's an example of what's called the coupon collector's problem. That's where you've got N things you want to collect, and you want to get all of them. However, not only do you pick them at random, but you've got replacement. So you could always pick the same one again later on. The question is, how many times, on average, if you want to collect N coupons, or in this case, N seconds in your times, how long is that going to take? Like, how many times are you going to have to do that before it happens? Of course, we can work it out with mathematics. Before we do that, just a quick sense check. For the very first time you do a park run, you're going to get a new time. And the second time you do it, well, you're probably going to get a new time because you've still got 59 of the 60 not yet collected. And as you go further and further into it, it becomes gradually less and less likely until finally, at the very end, you've only got one time outstanding. You've got 59 of the 60 and you're thinking, well, surely I'm going to complete my park run bingo any moment now. The issue is there are 60 seconds in a minute. So there's 60 different values you have to collect. However, there are only 52 weeks in the year, and 60 is a bigger number than 52. So you think I've only got one left, but on average, it's going to take you over a year of doing weekly park runs before you get that very last value. I'm aware I've put a lot of props on the table. I probably didn't need to make the very simple point that 60 is bigger than 52. In fact, what I've done is on my table I've got here, I've put unnecessary props. Allow me to demonstrate. So I've put the calendar on this side of my table, and then I've put my clock on this side of the table, and all these props weren't strictly needed to make an otherwise very simple point that I've got too many props. What I'm trying to say is some people run park runs and some people make unnecessary scale models for a recursion joke, and they're all perfectly valid hobbies. Ah, you know I did. There it is. Okay, so there's the next one down. Another 10% scale. I think that was definitely worth the extra effort. Quick sense check before we start. If we come up with a formula for N coupons to give us the expected number of trials, that should be a formula which keeps getting bigger and bigger and bigger, because as you have more and more coupons, it's always gonna take a bit longer to get them all. So the formula we come up with shouldn't it shouldn't converge on a limit, it should be some kind of formula that keeps getting bigger forever. And the thing to bear in mind is if something has a probability of P of happening, then the amount of time you normally have to wait for that to occur, so the expected time you wait equals 1 over P. It's the inverse of that probability. So for example, if there's a 1 in 52 chance of picking a card at random out of a deck, and then you start doing it over and over again to try and get a specific card, then that will take you, on average, 52 times. Now, this may sound obvious, but to get all the coupons, you have to get all the coupons. So for coupons all, that means you've got to get the first coupon, and then you've got to get the second coupon, then you've got to get all the way up to the ith coupon, and then you carry on all the way until the nth coupon, and then you've got all n of them. And by coupons, I'm just meaning the times people are getting here. So actually, the total time required is the time to get the first coupon, then you add on the extra time it's going to take to get the second one, and then you add on the extra time it's going to take to get the next one, up to the ith one, all the way up to the nth one. So what we have to do is work out how long will it take us to get the ith one, and then sum that from the first one all the way up to the nth one.
Quick clarification, when I'm saying the first coupon, the second coupon, etc., I don't mean the values of the coupons, or in this case, the value of the seconds. By first coupon, I just mean the first one you happen to collect. It could be any of the coupons, it's the first one to you. Okay, as you were.
Okay, a quick example just to get a sense of the ith coupon. Let's say we do Emily's. Emily has done 55. So she's currently after I equals 56, the 56th coupon. Now, to get the 56th coupon, there's only 5 left that she hasn't got. So the probability is going to be the 5 left that she hasn't got, any of those, out of the 60 total ones. Well, how do we get 5? Well, we knew that the 56th coupon means there's 55 she's already got. And then this value up here, what we did was we took 60, the total number, subtract how many she already had. So we subtracted 55. So if we want to do that in general, then what we've done is the probability of getting coupon I equals the total number you could have, so N, subtract how many you've already got, and you've got one fewer than the ith value, so that is I subtract 1, and it's out of N. Oh, and I could simplify that. I could take the brackets out. That would be N minus I plus 1. Actually, you know what? Let's pop that down here. So the probability is actually N minus I plus 1 all over N, which means the time it takes to get the ith coupon is just the inverse of that. So it's N divided by N minus I plus 1. And we are almost there. Just like almost everyone has finished their park run. I'll get to the conclusion now. So the total time is going to equal the first coupon plus the second one plus the next one all the way down. And instead of doing this back in our general term, I'm now going to do it specifically for a park run. So the time for the very first one is the inverse of the first probability, which is 60 out of 60. Well, that's easy, 60 out of 60. Then the next one's the inverse of 59 out of 60, so 60 over 59. And then the next one is the inverse, 60 over 58. And then that carries all the way down until when you're finally finishing, you got 60 out of 3 plus 60 out of 2 plus 60 out of 1, which I can rearrange to put the 60, so that's the N out the front. And, oh, you know what? I'm just going to reverse the order of these. So if you flip them around, and I'm going to start by writing this the last one first, then it's 1/1 plus a half plus a third plus all the way up to 1/60. So it's 60 outside of the harmonic sequence. It's 60 out the front of every single unit fraction being sum. So actually, if you want to put that back into general terms, it equals n outside of the harmonic series all the way up to the nth term in the harmonic series. What we said at the beginning is we expect whatever this formula is for the number of attempts it's going to take to always increase forever, and n is finite, and so we've just managed to prove that the harmonic series
diverges.
It's proof by running around a park. So if you actually run the numbers on all of that for a park run for the harmonic series up to 60, the total time equals, I don't want to judge, but I feel like we're reaching the end of the field of runners. It equals 181 rounded to the nearest whole number of park runs. So, oh, sorry, 281 rounded to the nearest whole number of park runs. And Geoff did it in fewer than that. So there you are, Geoff is below average. All right, let's go close off the narrative. See what we got. Can you have us in? Matt, how many seconds? First of all, how was your time?
So I'm happy with the time.
Yep.
I had a 1 in 10 chance, and I thought it was getting towards like the 21 thing.
Yeah.
So all of it down there, so 21.43, oh, missed that, 21.47, missed that, 20.49, missed that, but the finish was in sight. I just got over the finish.
Yeah.
The game was 22.02. My watch said 22.03.
The official time.
But what happened?
So we're waiting for the official time.
So we've handed in, you hand in your token and your scanner.
Oh.
They now go away. So Matt,
so we don't know yet.
So Matt's going to patiently wait a couple of hours for the run director.
A couple of hours.
Don't diss part run.
Grab a cup of tea or something.
And what happens? At about midday, you sent a text and your phone appears and everybody like jumps on the website, and that's when the official time comes through. So quite often, yeah, your time.
That's not how YouTube works. We need closure now.
So join us after the break when Matt will be looking slightly less disappointed.
Sometime later.
As we'll wait for the official time.
Oh my goodness. All right, Geoff has finished his run, and I've actually got, this is the graph I made for you.
That's me.
On that train trip.
We sat.
Way back in the day. And you can see at the beginning here, you start off really nice and linear. Bam, 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 bam. So one after the other.
It took me about 17 to get my first repetition.
Yeah, okay. Then you got a few reps in a row.
Okay.
And then this is still not far off linear.
I had a little nice run there of about 10 with no repetitions.
And then another drought. And it gradually flattens out. And actually, at the end here, you did, oops, too far. You did, it's only like 29 or 30?
I think it was like 229, I think, yeah.
Oh, no, but on your last one, to get your last one, you did it in way faster than you'd expect.
So what are the chances of the last one? What as a percentage?
Well, it should take you on average another 60 runs to get the very last one.
Sure.
And you did it in, I think, under 30.
Okay.
So you were way ahead. And overall, the expected number of runs for the whole thing is 281.
So I was 229.
You were 229?
So I was ahead.
Way ahead.
Way ahead.
Way ahead.
But some poor people do like 500 runs and
never quite make it. I am curious, because you were telling me this attempt, like when people are trying to game the system and like slow down or speed up, it's called sandbagging.
Sandbagging, yeah.
And it seems quite prevalent. Not going to lie. I feel like a lot of, and were you sandbagging some of these?
I may have. I remember needing 57 seconds. And part of me is like, if I slow down.
So it's
a
probably
bit.
A clump of your times. around 57.
The very last one. Yeah. There might be a little clump around the 57 mark. On the very last one, I think it
would be interesting to look at the actual stats and see, because the theoretical number of attempts is 281. I suspect it's going to be.
So take out the time when I did it and see how long it would take me to actually do it.
I think if you got a lot of people's data, you'd get a bimodal distribution, because there'd be one peak early on for people who've been sandbagging and trying to get the full bingo, and there'd be another peak for people who are blissfully unaware of the notion of this bingo, and they'll be at 281-ish, and there'd be another more spread out one earlier on.
They're like the pure control.
Okay. I'll plot those stats afterwards if I can find them.
Okay. So next time, will you actually come and do the run?
Nah, I've hung up my. I remember when I was a runner, my knees didn't take it, so I switched to cycling.
Much more healthy.
Low impact.
Thanks for coming to Guildford. Thanks for.
My pleasure.
Thanks for taking 20 months to reply to my email.
Geoff Marshall. He's got a YouTube channel.
Thanks for watching the video. If you like transport infrastructure videos, you absolutely should check out Geoff's channel. And if you enjoy socially running for precisely 5,000 meters, do check out your local park run. But now, I feel like we need some closure.